Looking at the weather today, we bless the name of the Lord. How are we wherever we are? Today, we'll be looking at transportation and industries in Nigeria. That's all we have today. I come again, transportation and industries. We have talked about the location, position, and size of Nigeria. We have talked about the states found in the southeast, the southwest, north central, northeast, and the northwest. We have discussed all these states. In this case, we have industries, and then we have airports and so many other things. These are things we are going to look at today. After or having known all these things or can look at them in the map, we should also look at the industries and the mode of transportation in these areas. Looking at the topic transportation and industries in Nigeria, we have objectives, what we intend to achieve in our usual way. At the end of this lesson, you should be able to, one, identify the major modes of transportation in Nigeria, two, discuss the advantages and disadvantages of these different transportation modes, three, define manufacturing industries, four, identify these industries or classify them. Five, locate major industrial zones on Nigeria. And lastly, discuss the location of industry in Nigeria. These are things we need to look at or intend to achieve today. Then we come to transportation. Transportation simply means movement of goods or commodities or people from one place to another. Could be done by road, or that is land, could be done by air, by water. There are different modes. Also, these are the modes we are talking about. It simply means moving goods or people from one place to another. That is the definition of transportation. Then we need to look at the types of transportation. We have one, land transport. That is under the types of transportation. We have the land transport. Then this one means moving goods or people from one place to another by land, not water or air. That is, this one is done. Then this one is also subdivided into many forms or categories. One called human porterage, that is use of human leg. Use your leg to transport or to move goods or people from a woman carrying a baby, backing a baby, is transporting that baby from one place to another, is doing human portrait. This person is carrying goods or load at the back. This is human portrait too. Then we have another one called animal portrait. That's use of animal, as the name implies, to move goods or people from one place or commodity from one place to another. This one is a camel carrying somebody. These ones, they are saying in the olden days, especially when there was no jeep or car, the rich people, they use the camel, and especially the king and the politicians then, they use these things. While the poor ones, they use their own leg to walk. But this one is still in existence today, but not as common as the olden days. It's called animal poultry. Then we have use of road too. That is using bike or motor or bicycle or whatever to transport on the road. That is what you are saying here. This is a motor or a car that is moving people from one place to another. These are the forms of transportation, most forms under land transport. We also have the division of the road too that we're talking about. We have talked about animal poultry. Then we also have the division of this road. When we talk about road transport, we have division of this road too. These roads are divided as trunk A, trunk B, trunk C. Trunk A roads are the roads that are constructed by federal government. And it is the federal government that maintains those roads. That is what we call trunk A road. Example is Oshodi-Apapa Road, Lagos-Ibadan Road, and so many others. We call them a May Express. Some people call them May Express. Then we have trunk B, those constructed and maintained by the state government, like Ketu Ikorodu Road, Ojota, Ikeja Road, and so within the state there. Then we also have Truck C, those that are constructed and maintained by the local government. Local government does not really have money compared to federal and state government. So in most cases, they don't have the road. They are same way, they just constructed them, maybe the use of a grader and so many, especially during dry season. These are Truck C Road. They are called Truck C Road. Then we have advantages of this transportation, road transport we are looking at. It is most common means, even poor man use it. Poor man cannot enter plane or fly or board a plane, but poor man can enter a car. It provides door-to-door service. Providing door-to-door service means plane cannot come to, jet cannot come to pick you in your house when you want to transport, but a bike can take you from the house and take you to the other place, the place you are going to, your destination. That's the door-to-door we mean. Then it feeds water and rail and other means of transportation. That is, for you to get to the airport, because it's not located in your house, you need to take bike first and follow the road before you now get. So it is the road transport that brings customer to the other means. That's what we mean by feeding them. Then these advantages are very expensive to construct road and maintain. It is more prone to accident compared to others. People die majorly on the road compared to other means of transportation. The amount of goods that are carried are limited. They are not too much goods that are carried on car and other. They also have another means of road transportation called the rail transport. This one is use of train to transport on the road, where in most cases they pass through the forest and so they open up new lands. They construct road, they just open up the land. People were not there before, they open the land. They will now discover so many some things there. It is very slow. The train, use of train is very, very slow. Then we also need to look at, outside this land, we need to look at the other mode of transportation, that is air transport. It involves the use of aeroplane, helicopter, rocket, jet, and so on for traveling from one place to another. By air, this time around, not land, by air. Aeroplane take off and they land in a place called the airport. We have the international airport and the local airport. The international airports are the airports you board a plane and then the plane is flying outside the country or coming from outside the country. They land there. Those are the international airports. Example is Nnamdi Azikiwe Airport. Other Abuja International Airport and so many other. Then we have local airports. Those ones are found, that is, the plane run within the country. For example, Benin Airport, you can move, board a plane there, then you get to Lagos or to Abuja within. You cannot take a plane or fly a plane from there to outside the country. Or a plane cannot come from outside and land in that airport. That is the local airport too. We have Benin Airport, we have Enugu Airport, and so many other local airports. Those are the what we mean by them. These are the this is the picture. This symbol means local airport, the small plane you are seeing here. Then the big one means international airport. This one is Makurdi, Benue State. Benue State is a small airport. You are seeing another one, Jos, Plateau State, small, but this is not central. This is Kano. You are seeing here, this one is a big one. This one is not a small one. This is international airport. Then Lagos here, we have international airport. In short, this is where most of the cases, coronavirus issue came through to Lagos. This is international airport in Lagos and Abuja. This is another one in Abuja. These two airports, and then Kano too. These are the major airports where this problem came from as it was starting before the community sharing. So these are the major airports. Then these smaller ones you are seeing, they are like this Calabar is a local airport. Port Harcourt Airport here is an international one too. So the bigger one signifies the international airport, while the small one here signifies the local airport. These are the airports we have. And there are locations too. Port Harcourt is south-south, remember? Calabar is south-south, Enugu, south-east. You can understand Abuja here is north-central, Akure is Akure, southwest. Benin is south south, Lagos southwest, Ibadan southwest. This Ilorin, that is Kwara State, north central. Please take note of all these states. We have done all this map and the place. Then we need to look at this Abuja International Airport. This is an airport loop. If you have time, you can just visit an airport, feel your eyes and see how an airport look. This is a picture of Abuja International Airport. We also need to look at advantages and disadvantages of air transport. One, it is the fastest means. You take a plane, you've seen a plane here, very fast. Within a couple of minutes, it has landed. Then it uses direct route, not like motor with corner like this and go like this and go like this. Once they start, they move direct. It can cross highlands, like you are seeing, and mountains and ocean, like you're seeing here. It is water, river, sea. It will cross it, not to put bridge. It can cross mountains and even trees in the forest. The disadvantages are expensive, very expensive to operate and maintain. To get this plane and maintain it, it's not something you're buying a car, 504 car. Expensive in terms of charge too. Poor man, like I've told you, does not use this. Easily affected by bad weather. When you say better weather, visibility is low. That means the weather, there could be cloud in the morning when it's about to rain. They will be told, the pilot will be told, the meteorologist will tell them not to fly because if they cannot see, it can cause an accident on the road for them. Then we have another form called pipeline transport. This one is not by air. Pipeline transport is the movement of goods or materials like the petroleum, crude oil, from one place to another through pipeline. Like we have this crude oil we have in Nigeria, they are mainly seen in the south part zone of this country. Like Port Harcourt, Warri, that's Delta State. They are channeled to some areas like Lagos. You have pipe they use to take them. Even some are seen in the village or interior area. Then you will drain them from there to the town where they are being refined. That is what we call transporting them. That is the meaning of the pipeline transport. That's what you are saying here. Moving materials from one place to another through the pipeline. Another mode of transportation is the water transport. This one is the movement of goods using water. It is divided into two, ocean navigation and inland navigation. Ocean navigation is use of sea and ocean to transport. Like you are seeing here, ship moving on the ocean, on the sea, you are seeing here, it is called ocean navigation. Then using of river, lakes, lagoon, and other smaller water bodies, drainage. Now, it means the inland navigation. That is the second part of it for transporting people. Then it also have its own advantages and disadvantages. Cost of construction and maintenance of a ship and all cost of construction and maintaining the river is low compared to the road. Because river is already natural something that is there. You may just dredge and clear the road, that's all. It is relatively safe compared to road. People die much on the road than that of this. Then ocean is free for all nations to use. You don't say this is my country and so it's only me that use it. Every nation can transport through the water. Then some of the disadvantages are cost of acquiring ship is very high. Ship is not like a 504 or so. It takes time. Ship, it takes time to get to the destination, unlike the plane that fly very fast. Then we have where this ship also, like the airport, where they land, called ports. Where they take off from and where they land, they are called ports. The ports are divided as seaport and river ports. The seaports are the larger one with large terminals, where big ship, they come, they land and they take off from. Then the smaller one are called river ports, where the smaller ship, or this canoe and others, they take off and they return to. The example of the river port is Warri port. Then we talk about the seaport. We have Apapa seaport. That's a very good example of the seaport that we have. It's found in Lagos, Apapa seaport. Then another thing we need to look at is around the sea or close to the sea, we have what we call hinterland of a port. It is that area, the particular land behind the port, which supplies it with exports. That is what is going to leave the country through that water. It is that land from there they bring it from. Then what the port also have gotten from another country, that's the import, it also give it to that land. From that land, it enters into the country too. That is what we call hinterland of import. That's what we call the hinterland of import. Then we also need to look at another thing for today, that is the manufacturing industry. It means turning raw materials into new products. This one is subsection. Remember, we're talking about transportation and industry. Turning raw materials into new products by mechanical or chemical processes. If you do it at home, you do small things, turning, you get beans, you turn it to mame and all these things you do, do it at home, it is called cottage. If it is done in the home, that is the cottage we are talking about. Then another one is, it could be done in the factory or companies, that is another method. So this turning of new raw materials into new products could be done at home or in the factory. There are two ways. You have the knowledge, you could do it at home. This is Western Industrial Zone. You are seeing here, this is what I say. This is Abeokuta, this Ekpe, this Oshogbo, this Ilorin. These are zones at the western side. Then this North Central Industrial Zone, you are seeing Kano here. This one is clothing some part of the Northeast and Northwest, adding to the North Central. This is Zaria, Kaduna. Then Southeast Industrial Zone. We have Kumwa here, this Abia State. These are Southeast. Then we have Midwest Industrial Zone. This is where you talk about the Sapele, Benin, and so. These are the industrial zones we have. Areas where we have these industries, like I've told you, in the country. Then we also need to look at classification of these industries. They are classified as light industry. These are industries, but they are also called secondary industries. They may produce light goods. From the word light, what they produce are not heavy, they are light, like the matches, they produce the hook. They also have consumer goods industry. This one, they turn raw materials into consumable goods, the goods that you take. So they are normally found in cities. Then we have another one called heavy industry. They produce heavy or bulky goods, like the ship, like the vehicle, and so many others. The industries can also be classified into primary, secondary, tertiary, and quaternary. These primary ones are the ones that extract the raw materials. Then the secondary ones, the mining industry, fishing, and so many others. The secondary ones, they now turn these raw materials into finished goods. These ones are like the chemical industries and all. Then we have the tertiary. These ones, they are concerned with rendering service like the bank. Then another thing is the quaternary industries is another form of industry. These ones, they are based on pure knowledge and skill of persons. The people go there for consultation or research or consultation. Like you have a research industry, ICT center, where you go to consult something, you look for knowledge. That is what these people, this industry is meant for. You have consulting firm today. People just go there, you have issue with people, they go there to seek for, you want to build a house, for example, business consulting firm, you want to build a house, you just go there. These are continental industry. Go there, they are made, they don't do production. You go to take advice. How do you go about this business so that you don't spend less or spend more? These industries are concerned with those things. That's what we mean by that. Then we also need to look at factors that affect the location of industries. Location of industries means siting an industry in a particular area. These factors are proximity to source of raw material. If you want to put an industry in a place, you need to think of where you will get this raw material that you want to use. You are producing perishable goods or bulky goods like cement. You should put it close to where you have the raw materials. You know what it's used for? To make cement, limestone. Don't make the industry to be far away. Another thing is nearness to market. You produce perishable goods. You are carrying things like this chemical, and it's in flask, bottle. You are not setting an industry very far from where you get the raw material, where you sell it. You know that before you move it from that industry to the market, most of these bottles will have been destroyed. Another thing is nearness to source of power. There should be stable power for these industries to work. Then availability of labor, whether skilled or unskilled. you should think of people that will come to work there. You cannot set up industry and you alone will be working there where you need like thousands of people. Then lastly, we have a political stability. A stable government grows industry. Today, you have PDP takeover, they change pattern. Tomorrow, APC takeover, they change pattern. These things affect location of industries. We also, having said this, also need to look at concentration of industries called localization of industry. It is the localization of industry, is the concentration of industry in a particular area. That is, concentration of industry in a particular zone. Advantages of this concentration means it creates employment. Where you have plenty of industries, like you are seeing here, employment will be there. People will get employment. It leads to provision of social amenities. Where you have these industries, there will be road and pipeline and others. Then some of the disadvantages is that it can escalate crime because people are not much in the area, like kidnapping, car snatching, and all. It can also cause environmental pollution and so many others because this industry is releasing gas or smoke. This one is releasing smoke. This one is releasing smoke. You'll be having all these things as a pollutant to the environment. Then, where as industries, industrial sector, make Nigeria economy good, but if they don't good to Nigeria economy to develop the economy, they employ people, they give income, they pay tax, so government get income. They develop people, those that work there, they have skills. Then they diversify the economy. If it is agricultural economy that we are relying on, and then banking sector now come, people will be shifting from year to year. So now we're having diversification. That is what we mean by that. Plenty of things to be done at once. Then problems of this industry to Nigeria, after contributing, they have also had some problems that they will face, or these industries that they face. There's shortage of raw material. We do not have enough raw material, you cannot produce. Another one, corrupt management or poor management. People just squander money and eat money anyhow, or they don't know how to manage the economy or the industry. Inadequate transport facility. There should be good transport facility. Then political instability. Like I've said, PDP takeover today, APC takeover tomorrow, just like that. The solutions to number one is number two. The solution to number one problem. Local sourcing of raw material. You go within to get raw material. Don't depend on push and other things too. Organizational management courses. When you have corrupt management or poor, you manage them. You arrest courses day to day or time to time. You go for training. Then provision of transport facility like good roads. There should be a stable government because stable government will enable foreign investors to come and then establish in industry or locate or set an industry in an area. So we need to also have a recap of what we have been saying. Number one, we said we talked about transportation. We said it's movement of goods of people or community from one place to another, either by land or by road. By road or land or by air or by water. We discussed the advantages of this form of transportation: the air transport, the water transport, and the land transport. Say the water is divided into two: ocean navigation and inland navigation. Also talked about the road having trunk A, trunk B, and trunk C. Also talked about advantages and disadvantages of these forms. And then we talked about the industry, manufacturing industry. We talked about the types of industry, the primary, the secondary, and the tertiary, and then quaternary. We also talked about the light industry that produce light goods. We talked about the heavy industries and so many others that produce heavy goods like the ship and the car. We've also looked at location of industries, setting an industry in an area, and the factors to be considered while doing that. Talk about nearness to market, nearness to source of power, and so many others. We've also talked about localization of industry, that's concentration of industry in a particular area. Then we've also looked at the areas industry as or industrial sector has contributed to Nigeria economy, the provision of employment, diversification of economy, and also we looked at the problems of these industries too. pollution to the economy. And so then we also talked about the problems of this industry, that they face, the manufacturing, we talked about poor management or corrupt management. We talked about government instability. We also foster or talked about the solutions to these problems, like courses being organized by the management or regular management courses. Then we talked about provision of transport facility. We talked about local sourcing of raw materials and so many other things. Remain blessed as you watch the video. Do whatever you're supposed to do as assignment. Read very well. Don't just watch for entertainment, but watch to learn. Thank you very much. God bless you. Stay by.